station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Dan Hewitt. A Russian cargo craft was lost during its flight into space. The Russian Progress 65 lifted off from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan on time on December 1st. The flight was normal until just over 6 minutes when Russian ground controllers stopped receiving telemetry data from the vehicle. Preliminary information from Roscosmos indicates the vehicle was lost over an unpopulated and mountainous area, with most of the craft burning up in the atmosphere. The loss of the cargo ship will not affect the station's normal operations, and supplies aboard remain at good levels. This was a packed week with close to 70 hours of science work scheduled for the crew. They worked on several experiments, including the European MARES device set up by Thomas Pesquet, which is researching the effects of microgravity on the muscular system. Commander Shane Kimbrough set up hardware for the Marangoni experiment, which investigates the physics of surface tension where liquid and gas meet, an important facet of heat exchangers in space and clinical diagnostics here on Earth. Peggy Whitson was even able to do a demonstration to help NASA flight surgeons figure out the best way to remove air bubbles from an IV fluid bag in case they are ever needed for a sick crew member. This week, Twitter user Alpha Adhito wants to know what the station crew does if there's a fire on board. That's a great question and an important part of any astronaut's training before flight. Every station crew practices fighting fires before flight at the Space Vehicle Mock-up facility here in Houston. The station has smoke detectors that can immediately warn the crew. To suppress any fire, there are extinguishers that use either carbon dioxide, a fine water mist, or a water-based extinguishing foam. They also have oxygen masks available and handheld sensors to test the atmosphere for combustion products. Keep sending in your questions using the hashtag SpaceToGround. We'll see you next week.